It is finally like the automotive industry is coming of age when it comes to performance-oriented small cars. For the longest time, we have had a lot of chatter around Maruti trying to bring in the Swift Sport to India, but that is still a pipe dream. It is Maruti's arch rival Hyundai that is trying to intensify the game with the latest i20 after Volkswagen set the ball rolling with the GT range of its Polo. And for Tata, well, they have this. It is the latest Altroz with a turbocharged petrol engine. It is the Altroz iTurbo. Altroz iTurbo. You might think, wow, finally a serious performance effort by Tata. But this is not new to the company, doing special performance variants, that is. Remember, they were the JTB duo of Tiago and Tigor? But, you know, beyond that, I will take you further back in time to when Tata had done a couple of special 00 rally cars. These were basically IndyCars that consumed some serious steroids and blasted down the rally stages without really falling to pieces. They were absolutely awesome. This is not as hardcore as that, but there is a sense of indestructibility about the Altroz, and it's got huge praise for its results from the global NCAP. So you have data to fall back on as well. From the sound it makes when you shut the door to the heft of the platform you feel underneath when you're seated in, the feeling is that of reassurance. It's almost like that is a way of the car expressing to you that, hey, relax, you know, I've got this. The Altroz really catches the eye. The surface styling is cool with many interesting things going on. The front with a two-layer treatment for the lights. Then you have the profile with that proper flat slab of plastic running all through the belt line. And the rear is absolutely mind-boggling. All this combined make it the best-looking hatchback in the segment. And I will go as far to say that it is possibly the best-looking hatchback in the country right now. But beyond this sense of sophistication, the gorgeous and very interesting shape is a car that does not really feel like it is the same product. The quality and the feel of the cabin is still not at the level of the best out there. In fact, the moment you sit and hold the steering wheel itself, it's these plastic bits over here that just put you off completely. It is a very blatant, very raw sort of a plastic element, and it's sharp at the edges. And while, yes, you know, the overall look of the dash with its three-color treatment may appeal to some, it does not really have that sense of sophistication and leaves a lot to be desired. Even the reflection in the windscreen, that is also fairly noticeable, so it can get a little troublesome sometimes. And the less we talk about the instrument cluster, the better it is, because it is not even in the same decade as the rivals. But there are other attributes which are very good. The space, for example, that is immense. It is plenty, and you can really stretch your limbs absolutely easily in here. The seats, they are also fairly good, fairly decent. You will not really complain even after sitting in for a few hours. So full marks over there for space and fairly decent seats as well. Now, features. You do get a fair bit. You have Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. There is a voice command system as well, which kind of is a little slow to respond, but it reads your inputs very well, so that's pretty all right. And there is cruise control. In addition to all this, there is something called EDA. Now, that is Tata's equivalent of BlueLink or Yuvo Connect by Hyundai and Kia. And that is Tata telling you that they have connected car technology. So, fairly basic and very similar stuff to the rivals. You can lock and unlock your car remotely. You get all the basic info. You can track the car if it gets stolen. And you can geofence it. All these kind of stuff. And apart from all this, there is one thing that really disappoints me. That is the screen over here, right in the middle. One, it's angled towards the co-passenger. It's not like how people generally do, angle it towards the driver. This one is the opposite. And it's not really comparable to the rivals in the segment. But enough about design and features. This new variant in this really striking new blue color is all about the iTurbo badge. which means it has a 1.2-liter three-cylinder turbo petrol engine that has 110 bhp and 140 newton meter flowing through its veins. First impressions. Well, it does not really sound too good. It's a thrashy and unpleasant sound, which does not change or get better with the build-up of speed as well. And the outright performance is just about okay. It's not like the i20 turbo, which feels quite zestful compared to this one. But that does not mean that it is not a gain. In fact, it is a significant improvement over the 1.2-liter petrol engine that you get in the regular version of the Altroz. But this one is just, it makes you want more, especially because the chassis itself feels extremely capable. In fact, it always has been very capable, and I think it can handle a lot more power. How about the other things? Well, the gearbox feels average at best. The shifts are slick, no doubt about it, but there is a little rubbery feel at the linkage, and it does not really feel very crisp. The throws, they're also fairly long, especially for a version that is supposed to be a performance version. I would have wanted the shift action or the throws to be nice and short. So yeah, it's really not delivering on the experience I really wanted from the Altroz iTurbo. The steering, well, nothing to really write home about. It's not the quickest rack out there. It's not the most enjoyable system. And again, not really in sync with the nature of what a performance version of such a capable car should really have been. And because this is the sportier variant of the Altroz, it of course has to have a sport button, and it is right here. But it does not really do a lot of difference. It does not make a night and day difference to the way the car behaves. And yes, it's sure, you know, it gives you that slight bit of perkiness, but you know what? It's really not immediately noticeable. And I think if you are in the mood, even in the normal mode, just get on the throttle with a heavy foot and you will be able to enjoy whatever little you can. But this, I don't understand the point of it. The Altroz iTurbo also has something called corner stability control. And unfortunately, I've not been able to exploit the dynamic boundaries of the Altroz to be able to really notice the corner stability control coming in or kicking in. So I would definitely want to get this car again, throw it around some really nice and sharp bends, probably take it to a racetrack to really just throw it and thrash the nuts of this car. Only then will I be essentially able to see what exactly the corner stability control feels like in this package. So I can't really tell you about that, at least at this point of time. So while it is a variant that's born out of good intent, in practice, it still feels like the performance threshold was much higher than what Tata Motors settled for. Honestly, I think this car, it needs 150 bhp or thereabouts. In fact, it desires it almost. And this was the perfect chance for Tata to set itself apart from the other performance hatchbacks in the market. But I guess there is always another time.